Hello and welcome to Split 4, Race 2, here in Season 8, and at a Malaysia Sepang International Circuit. Today I'm with Isa Musing and Stelling Decay from some of the other splits.
Hello!
And we're probably going to go in a couple of seconds over to qualifying comparison with Isa Musing.
Yeah, so what do you guys expect of this race?
I think it's going to be mayhem, personally. This track is not an easy one if you get it wrong, and there's lots of gravel. So, I'll go to the qualifying comparison now, and as I said, this track is pretty difficult to get right because of the long turns, so let's see, as we have Vice Guy against Scott Gameplays HD. So, Scott gets it a bit wide into turn one, and both of them nail turn two, pretty much. So, I'd expect them to be about the same pace at the moment, which is probably about right. Yep, they are about the same pace. So coming into turn four, it's a very tricky one to not corner cut there. Both of them just about keeping it within the corner cutting phase. And going over these curves is crucial to get it over the second curve, otherwise you'd go wide like Scott Gameplay did. Again, these times, clip the curves. You know, just keep it straight, keep it on the gears, high revs if you can, because it'll help you turn in. And again, Scott goes wide, but it looks like he's a bit faster than Vice at the moment. So now into this tricky complex of turns where you can't get it wrong, otherwise you outbreak yourself into the next turn. Turn it left, then turn it right, and now onto the braking zone for Scott Gameplay HD. And he gets wide again, so not a great lap from both of them, as Vice Guy is now visibly further behind. And on the DRS, both of them down to the last corner, braking very hard into here. Oh, locks up a bit for Scott HD Gameplays. And I got the name wrong again, so he gets 8th on the board, and Vice Guy goes 9th. So what did they get? So, Scott's game 10th and 11th, so a bit far off the pace, with Crotafol 93 on pole, and lots of different nationalities, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, but also think if you notice it, Vice Guy had fuel for 13 laps more, so I think he was just using the qualifying as a practice because he knew he weren't fast enough anyway, so.
Also, we got a Miran, or Mifran, or however you sort of pronounce his name, got a qualifying ban because the first race at Australian,
because of the accident,
because of all the accident was happening, and somehow he got the penalty. And that,
hang on, lights are already going.
Yeah, that was pretty fast.
And away we go. Cool, I wasn't expecting that. And everybody getting a pretty standard start.
I was saying,
Winters getting a pretty good start, but losing out a bit now.
Yeah, it looks like he got a
aggressive driving, but it went well. Oh.
Yeah,
I don't think it's going to go well into turn two. They actually made it through the corner without crashing.
There are two cars down behind someone.
Yeah, I've just looked at the minimap. Nobody got through there without crashing. And turn three, what's that going to bring? Both Red Bulls colliding. There we go. Nice teammate battle.
Yeah, I must say that also the Lotus are providing some at the beginning. That's Armstrong going past that.
I think Armstrong and Yava, they're pretty much the same pace, so I think they're a good team to have.
I definitely think that
we'll get a lot of team battles.
I think that's probably the most consistent team we'll see this season, to be fair.
I wouldn't say consistent, because I think both Armstrong and Yava have a tendency to sometimes just disconnect for no reason.
Yeah.
And also Yava's history last season with crashing in the first corner and taking people out, so...
That wasn't Yava, that was Yodog.
Yeah, that was Yodog.
Ah, Yodog, yeah. But Yava did have a tendency to take people out. I knew he took me out once, but...
You were probably just gay.
Yeah, that's because I was in a Lotus.
I would say so far in this season, I haven't really seen anything from him where he was just flying over. He hasn't been doing that.
So we've got the DX3 sponsor again, so they'll be gaining some more sponsorship.
I don't know what just
happened.
He's rejoining, and now we've got a whip of style. Amazing point.
He just locked up.
We
got a sub from Vice Guy, and Vice Guy got a flying start, I must say. That was unbelievable done by Vice Guy. in about what, two positions and maybe one more.
And he gets smashed by an MG. And another one.
Squeezing. What's the MG doing? What the?
He was reversing into Vice Guy. What? That must have been a wrong year.
So he still got the winner last race.
Yeah, I think he won in Australia.
Yeah, well, he's got his cut out for him now.
Now we're gonna see a start from Miron.
Yeah, so we can see Vice Guy here on the right and still got just to the right of Miron.
Vice Guy just got the start amazing perfectly, I must say. And we can also see Miron's engine are overheating.
There we can see Steelbot.
I just have to ask, was it a good idea to give Miron qualifying ban if he was the one crashing into people during the race,
I don't think he got the penalties for the turn one incidents. I think it was later in the race. I think it was an incident with Armstrong later in lap one, and then I don't remember what the other incidents were.
I just a bit of lag there? Because
you're probably just lagging.
Yeah, I thought there was more cars on the screen, and then it just went away.
Yeah, and he's also hunting down Scott Gameplay's HD. But
we also have to defend from initialization.
Yeah, exactly, and initialization have really started to pace only in going a little bit wide there.
Yeah, I think a lot of drivers took these turns rather wide from time to time.
I totally agree on that. It's a rather difficult sector 2 from beginning, and of course down to this half in that too.
Stupid ass.
We can also see Scott Gimple Hasty going a little bit wide there, and he's losing the car.
No, I just think he moved away because he knew Miron was faster, and he wouldn't want to block him.
A lot of people have made that mistake, and that mistake in even split one, people making the mistake.
Also, if you look into the mirrors, you saw Intralization was forced to break too early. And taking a car.
Scott cut Miron off a bit there.
It looks like this is going to be an interesting race.
Yeah, I actually think, especially since no one has crashed yet.
Yeah,
he makes a stick.
But can he get on the throttle fast?
No, he doesn't have the best exit, so he's going to have to get behind him, get in the slipstream, and try it into turn one. Look at the slipstream already, reading him in. There you go, moves to the inside. Breaking.
What will
they go too wide? Oh, it is a season wreck on him now too.
How he didn't lock that up, I do not know. I think the rear wheels locked, but he turned in more and it was okay. So he's gained a place from that. Really good driving.
Yeah, I would say that. I totally agree. And now you're seeing Scott Gameplay HD where I think that's the replay of it.
Goes into lean. That's an interesting strategy when you're about to get past.
Yeah, well, I think it might be because he might want to save fuel in this part of the track because he knows that he might not be able to keep full throttle here anyway, so he might as well just go to lean.
But still, we got a straight here, kind of, where he still can get some pace, and now he's losing some pace at the top of his gears, which I don't think will benefit him. But as you're coming to Scott Gimby HD, a bit of
lap three, and look at those tires. As he locks up straight into the gravel, and that's really his afternoon gone from
once again.
Once again,
where's he going?
I do not understand that because his tires don't look that bad. I mean, they're orange, but they're not red.
I think the first time he crashed up in the second to last corner, I think he was just losing his turn a bit. And then he was coming to the pit exit, he locked up, and then he was too eager on the throttle and just kept spinning it.
Yeah, that was. But I must say that to the people outside, where we, of course, who are relegating this together, or eating this together, sorry. Amazing job by cutting these things together, so you can see that he failed two times. Of course, that's bad for a driver, but. Yeah. Oh, that's Kanaska Kupata, or however you pronounce that name.
Late move, and he's completely outbraced himself.
Just got tossed by Kanaska going into the pits.
Yeah, some slight contact, I think.
Yeah, I think that was definitely a racing incident because Kanaska had no idea of knowing that Vice Guy wouldn't go into the pits then.
Exactly, yes. Steel trying to go for outside, now looking for the.
We can see Steelbot, even though he was stopped in turn one, he's already up here in P5.
He's looking for the inside now. Can he get the moves done? That's the question. If he can outbreak him, no. Miron is really defending now. Maybe Steelbot's showing.
And Miron leaves room, I think, but that might have been it.
I think it was a hit then. I think that was a hit. But also, I do have to say, look at that sky. It doesn't look too good.
No, actually, yeah, dude, good you mentioned that, because I actually think that looks a little bit rainy, to be fair. Just maybe fill it. Oh,
bit of a corner cut.
And track extend from Steelbot, I think.
Yeah,
and, very controversial. He doesn't give the place back.
Yeah, but then again,
well, now he's given the place back.
Yeah, most likely. That was part of his plan, I also think.
Nah, I just think he lost control. And now you can see that's tires we need to get into.
That's proper tire wear.
Actually, I think I would say it's too early because it's only the front left which is destroyed.
Yeah.
The rest is perfectly fine to drive with.
But
so
you'd struggle into the fast corners.
There's about four corners or five corners where you need a good front left tire, and so you might just end up with it falling off the cliff, and that wouldn't be good at all.
Exactly.
Ooh, somebody getting held in the pits.
Yeah,
there.
I saw that too. That was an extra pit of bad for the McLaren driver. I think that was the McLaren, if I'm correct. Yeah, that's Winters getting held up.
So, not
hit, I think.
Oh, yeah, but Winters was in the pit and he just got held up, then he got left out then.
And there goes Vice.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, obviously he haven't pitted yet, I think. He's still in the shop.
It doesn't
tires?
Look like. Yeah, that's that
yeah,
part.
Yeah, that's tough. Definitely the option.
Yeah.
So I'm expecting.
Vice guy really has some tire wear problems.
I'm expecting Vice to get passed into this corner or the next one.
Yeah, he should. He's on way older tires and he's in general just slower than the rest of the field.
Oh,
looks
maybe.
Pretty fast on them. He had a pretty good turn in there, you know.
Yeah.
He wasn't slow.
Oh, and now we can
here
see,
we can see him struggling with keeping his line and then again.
Oh, are really fighting with the tires too to get them warmed up.
I think he's fighting with the cold tires here, and Vice Guy obviously have warm tires, so we have an advantage for the.
But one I think in lab, that simply moves on.
One thing I do notice about his driving style, though, he has a tendency to turn in a bit too much on as he turns into the corner, and then he lets off the turning, so that's just heating up the tires. Look, he turns off the steering, so it's heating up the tires for no reason.
That's a brave move. That's a brave move. That could have really fast been an incident if Vice Guy. Oh, nearly taking the cone, I think.
Yeah. So, you know, a lot of different driving styles. We'll see how that tire wear plays out.
Here we are with Scott on lap 6.
And Kroll L4.
Let's just call him Kroll from now on.
Yeah, we're gonna call him for Kroll. So, yeah, he's getting passed, but it looks like Scott.
He just got the DRS.
Yeah, that was close. I don't know why he keep looking over to him, because
I think he wants to know if he can get over to the position to get the optimum first corner.
Yeah, that's of course true, but
it's a bit of a lock up going wide here, but can he get on the throttle to keep his position?
Slide lock up that
again. I think he's got it. Yeah.
Looks like it.
Yeah, he squeezed him out.
He definitely shut the door down. And right hard indeed.
Well, he was entitled to do it, his racing line, so I don't really see what anybody could say about that.
Maybe two. Ooh.
Three wide. Nope. Two. Oh, nearly clipping the back of the Lotus there.
Oh, that was so close to that. What the?
I'm sorry to say, but that looks like that's.
I think that was some kind of weaving or very illegal defending. My eyes, that one.
Oh, who's that? That's Vice Guy.
God, there's so many tech. He's staying out a long time on those option tires.
Eight
that's too long.
That's 8 laps now.
Yeah,
and not
I actually think he was still doing faster and faster laps all the time.
And
it's just up his fuel, so I don't think he really saw the opponent from the pits. He was still faster
and faster. Exactly, and we are seeing Armstrong again speeding in the pit lane.
Yeah, every time.
But he actually leading the race. Impressive by that.
What do you expect with a pit stop like that?
He hasn't had to pit yet, so everyone else has had been to the pits.
Exactly. Thanks, Vice Guy. Two all spell down back there, and Vice Guy's tires are really starting to wear off now. We can see that.
But as you can see, we're still doing faster than his previous.
That's the time to pit, I think.
Yeah.
You know, now's the time where I'd be thinking, God, my tires are going off now. Really need to pit. Look at that turn in.
A disaster has befallen my wheels.
Oh yeah, definitely Vice Guy wheels probably soon, but we will find out if that gonna happen or not.
I think he's just driving now and defending as good as he can with these wheels and just trying to slow the rest down so he can get it easier catching them when he actually have pitted.
Oh, and now Scott Kemp is going a little bit wide back then. Vice Guy really spinning against that Red Bull behind him.
He's lost the place.
Oh, that's Sierra, yeah.
Yep.
Oh, and Bass Guy.
There we go. The tires have definitely gone now.
That's Scott going past too. So yeah, I think that's time for Bass Guy to decide to go into the pits. If not, that's probably gonna ruin the race. If not. So yeah, that's James behind him too, and Vasco locking up.
Yeah, that tire's definitely gone. It's hit the cliff, I think.
Yeah, not just hit the cliff, it's gone off the cliff.
Actually, surprisingly, he managed to keep it through the hairpin, where a lot of drivers actually crashed with fresh tires.
Yeah.
Now he's having Canis Brugge all over him.
Yeah, but I actually think if you're looking at him, he is driving very, if you can say that, slow in an F1 kind of style, of course if you're driving.
Yeah, not the best line into there.
Exactly, and that. Oh!
What the hell is he doing?
I don't know, but that tires is not helping him at all.
No, but still, he had to ride to the line on the outside, so you can't just smash him.
Nah.
That was just kind of aggressive, a bit too aggressive from Canesco.
No. So, he's in last place, unfortunately, so that's going to put him 20 seconds behind last place.
Yeah.
So, that maybe not that, the strategy didn't really pay off. I'm not sure.
Or will it? Because Vice Guy is definitely, as we can see now, he's going for a 2-stopper, and all the other guys are probably on a 3-stopper, I think,
He's already a pit stop behind.
Yeah. Okay,
now he's up with the pit stop and 20 seconds off. But if the rest of the guys still need to do 2 pit stops and he only have to do 1, if he has the same pace as the rest, he might catch them,
but they'll have fresher tires. And he has a chance if somebody makes a mistake.
Yeah, exactly.
But if nobody makes a mistake, I think it might be difficult on worn tires at the end of the race. He might catch them and pass them, but it will be difficult. Anyway, Meron in the pits.
That's.
Yeah, I actually think he was the last one to pit then.
Because he did.
We're on the front now, and he started on them as well. So.
Yeah, and where he's in seventh now? Did he got past Ego? Of course,
yeah,
being
no, he's in 11th. He's in 11th now.
Yeah.
There comes Kaneska, and you can see Vasca is still only on the back straight.
Yeah, so,
that's a bit too far back to do anything, I think.
Yeah, that's definitely true. But I think Vasca's strategy is to hoping that some people maybe do a lock up, spinning the cars into a wall, losing a fronting or something like that, hoping for the lock to him. But as you see, Armstrong really trying to hunt down Winters at the back straight. Actually, also got the DRS. That's crazy if you can get the move done up here.
That was a late break then. But he managed to get it done.
Yeah,
I would say that Winters is
probably have DRS.
Yeah.
And that'll be him past, probably, because there's no defending against that.
Yeah, but
now he doesn't.
But I must say that Winters did some. He opened the door for Armstrong and not closed it.
I think the problem was, had Winters closed the door, then Armstrong would just have smashed into him in both cars and both likely out of the race.
But it would just be
stupid for Winters to close the door.
But he could still maybe just close a little bit, not too much. Like
then they had contact, and maybe some of them lose the wing or spin, and then they lose more place. As you can see, there are two cars right behind them.
What he could have done was, you know, just close the door, but like really early on into the straight, you know, take the inside line in the middle of the straight, not at the end of it.
And then the problem is, if you don't break in time, then he might end up crashing his wheel, going way too wide, and then Armstrong does get past him anyway.
So you can also see Armstrong is really got the what's that called now?
Philippines, I don't know.
What?
Corner cut there.
Oh yeah, see, and the Winters car's flying.
Well, he got so much wheel spin coming out of that turn, it was ridiculous.
Yeah, that's
nice lock up, and that's not going to do the tires any good, I can tell you that.
No, but I think that Armstrong maybe got the advantages of going on a little bit faster compound as you're trying to just show his kind to
the inside.
That's contact, and that's Winters trying to get the wheels down again. And
I think Armstrong was just letting Winters pass. You can see he don't own his DRS, and now he opened it. Then Winters were on his side.
Yeah, so, but he still got the inside line, so that's.
Yeah, exactly.
So, Winters holds on.
Why to try and get on the inside?
No, and Winters covers that off, so he hasn't got anything. No.
Armstrong is really fine to get those rear wheels down to the ground. And
I also think the problem is, of course, on the softer compound, you lose your tires earlier than on the hard compound.
Yeah. That's it's lap 12, so yeah, he's going to be losing time now.
Yeah,
exactly. Especially pitting on lap 5, he's going to be losing time.
Exactly, and we've seen Scott going into the pits.
Primes confirmed.
So that's...
And that's a long pit lane to go down.
Yeah,
it takes an age to go down that pit lane. Yeah, it's just so long.
For a Formula 1 driver, that is waiting like an age or something
just,
like that.
It's just too
to sit at 60 for the whole pit lane.
That's a really interesting fight we definitely need to watch out for, but I think that can cause some very interesting fights. My position will be switching up and down again. So
plus, it's for second.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice racing all down the field.
Yeah.
It's almost like a replay of last time we saw him.
Yeah, I must say that Armstrong is really trying, but we can see that his front left is starting to wear a little bit up now in my eyes.
His rear right as well.
Yeah.
Now, really?
Well, this time he doesn't.
Inside and now Winters
Not
a slide there.
I think Winters might have this one again. He got a poor exit. Unless he used all of his curves now.
No.
I don't think he's going to get it. Nope.
No,
he's just...
Whoa.
What was that?
I think he was trying to mark himself in Winters' mirrors, but that backfired.
You don't turn when you have DRS on.
Exactly. He's not that much.
I think he was so close to losing control at the stray. But managed to just hold the car, and that's impressive done. But again, also a little bit stupid, but trying to mark himself so hard that he exited.
Also incredible that he hadn't lost that much time to Winters. You can see he's still very close now.
Exactly.
Made
I'm saying this really looks like that Winters is making a higher downfall.
Next lap, and he looks like he's coming into the pit.
Let's go.
Pollard. Never touch those in Formula 1 2013.
Especially
you never know what they
especially
can do.
Bahrain.
Exactly, Bahrain can kill you.
We're expecting about 2 finishers in Bahrain.
About 18 safety cars.
18 safety cars and 18 bollards that are going to take people out.
Oh, yeah. Seeing by the G overhead.
Oh, he's going too deep into there again. That's not the first time.
Nope, I'm saying that those was. Looks like you're having some problem with the brakes, to be fair. Because every time when you're seeing Malaj trying to go into the pits, he just going straight. It just looks like the brakes doesn't work.
I do have to add that I would never race with the Lotus again. It's a glitched car, in my opinion. too many glitches, mostly with curbs and all that. When you go over, for example, Monza, when you go over with a... like in qualifying, if you go over the curbs in multiplayer, it'll just, chuck you up in the air and you can't do anything about it. So,
Marin's coming to the pits as well.
Yeah, I think that's the pit window. It's definitely open now, of course, although pit stuff we're seeing.
Those options have lasted well, though. 15 laps.
He pitted around lap 9, I think it was.
About 7 laps. Yeah. That's still good on the options. And he's going options again.
That's so weird.
Prime option prime maybe.
There's
That's probably a sentence to do. Yeah.
In my opinion, I go if I'm doing that, I go prime option because at this rate, he'll be on lap. Well, what would he be? Lap 20, about 22 when he pits. So he'll have 6 laps to go on a fresh set of options.
He might do that. We don't know, but.
Yeah, we will see, but of course there's still many laps to go in this race, about, 11 or something. That's Merritt showing his car, that's maybe launching into the inside. Oh, that's a lot.
Oh, that was a good move. Good.
I would say he carried a little...
He's got blocked out again.
He really carried a lot of speed down to that first, into the little, second corner, sorry.
But he also had the best compound and most likely fresher tires, I would say.
And that's... Kanaska going, trying to take the fist line. That's letting Miran pass.
These people are brave in this split. They dare to take a move around the outside. You know, never do that.
I think people just is thinking if accident happened, then bad luck.
Shit. Yeah, exactly.
Might as well just go for it.
Exactly. Yeah. Now we're seeing Scott gameplay is going into the pits again.
As long as it's clean. Then I think it's awesome with all these fights instead of just I can't pass. I'm just gonna stay behind. It's way more fun. It's just getting into every corner at full speed and stuff like that.
So now you look like Scott have some fresh rubber to go on again now, but it's prime size, so that's
but he's probably just wondering if he can do option for the next 8 laps, so that's why he does.
So, Voskai taking a pretty big stint again.
Yeah, I must say
10 laps so far, I think.
Yeah, I think that that's a 2-star from Voskai, I must say.
Yeah, it should be. He's now doing a freestyle.
That's light. Can't say that. And that's pushing.
That's his chance of getting any places gone out the window, I think.
Yeah, I think Baiskai just gets a bit frustrated, whatever you call it, by him. Kineska in there, and then he just tries to get away, but gets too far away and just loses the corner completely.
Exactly. I think
he's got DRS, though, so he's got. Oh, he had DRS.
For some reason, it disappeared.
He had that going for him until
thank
the gate
you,
decided to take it away.
Thank you.
Stupid game.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, Vice are going into the pits. Let's see how good that will go.
I don't know. He didn't crash in going into the pits.
He got close to the barrier then, going into the...
I actually think he was just fooling around. It looked like he was trying to hit the barrier just for fun. He knew he would last anyway.
Well, let's see what the four senior boys can do. Pull off a great pit stop award.
Yeah,
3.16. Yeah, we
can see him going... Option prime or option strategy? That's interesting.
Options, 8 laps, could be possible.
Yeah,
I wouldn't attempt it, but it could be possible.
Yeah, but he did the first, 8-9 laps on options as well.
Now he's just trying
to stay away from the track.
Yeah,
that must be qualifying in first place.
Yeah, that's... As we know, Vyleskai is very aggressive star after that blue flag has gone let pass, so maybe we're gonna see a battle from them later in the race.
I don't think so.
There's no point in battling with the car that's like a lap ahead of you.
I don't think Baskai is battling with him. I just think he wants to sort of mark his territory and try to keep up with them, so he might be able to use them to overtake others. Because if they come up to, in this case, 12th place, then the 12th place will have to move away, and then Baskai can maybe get past as well.
Yeah.
So I think he's just trying to use them as slipstream as well, and DRS.
Oh, and that's Winter's flocking. Winter's Armstrong flocking.
He got held up in the pits, and it might cost him dearly against Winter. Oh, contact!
But I actually think that he should have let Winter's pass there, because he came out of the pits and almost got in the way of Winter's, which is illegal.
Yeah, that's Merrick going into the pits again now, so yeah.
So options or primes?
Yeah,
let's take bet.
I'll get options too.
I think he's gonna go primes.
No, but he started on prime, so we don't need to, and it would just be
That's option tires staying ready.
Yeah, that's option tires. So he obviously had a new set of option tires.
Yeah,
I didn't think he had a new set.
Yeah, he should have, because he didn't.
Oh, with qualifying ban.
He had qualifying ban, and I think you have 5 sets of each as well. So.
Yeah, I forgot about that. Yep, that's true.
Even in qualifying, you can use 2 sets, and then you still have 3 left.
So
once again, I'm beaten on the bets.
Yeah, also, you saw that the lights was blinking in the pit lane with the blue ones, because they're here. They are marking that a fast guy coming from behind, I think.
Yeah, they're marking that there is traffic when you exit the pit.
Exactly.
This is a pit stop, yeah. He's not going to go to the end on those tires, that's for sure.
No, that's option tires again, I think.
That's quite annoying, because he was in third, so he could have got a podium, but I don't think it's going to be close enough for him to...
The question is if other drivers will have to pit as well now, because if they will, then he might get the place back. He's still
in
third place, and they all came, 3 people right close to each other.
Yeah
there we go. Well, there's possibility if they're on old tires.
Yeah, not to mention they're very close to each other, so...
Oh, and there goes his teammate past, so...
Yeah.
Let's hope,
yeah, but we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cars just close to him. Here we can see
Armstrong and Winter's battling again. But did you guys saw that Steelboy was in second place? He was dropped down to 12, and now he's
off
in second.
That's pretty impressive.
Bit of flying cars.
That's Whipple Hack.
Yeah,
that's still Whipple Hack. That's Winter's really trying to mark him off in that, that's you have a nice stair, I think.
Yeah, it is. It's the other Whipple.
I think we can see a double pass, maybe. No, he's not going to use his curves.
Is he
going to
try and dive bomb once again?
I don't think so. I wouldn't dive bomb with Yavanaisday and Winters in front of me. Definitely not.
Yeah,
I don't want to be killed after the race.
Yeah, you're going to use all the curves now. But if you look at this, it looks like Winters got a little bit more downforce at his car, but he's really struggling to get past people.
He used the curves. Looks like he used curves.
Also, if you notice it, Armstrong having fuel plus 1 lap at the moment, so we have plenty of fuel to go and race for a longer time.
Pushed wide.
Nice team battle going on there.
So that's going to be maybe Yavanaisday can come back at Armstrong.
We will see, but Armstrong really struggling to get those tires down to the ground. And as we are cutting to Armstrong again.
And this is just later the same lap.
Yeah.
You can see he lost the lap a bit, but still is very close to Winters. The question is, can he get the podium ahead of Winters?
That's gonna be a very interesting fight. Also, he got still plus one lap, I think that's probably gonna help him so he can go on race at some of the last laps in the race. And yeah, as you're seeing going into race now, that should probably be moved on if Winter's not doing anything. No, he's
moved to the outside.
Yeah. That's correct.
Armstrong should probably just have braked a bit earlier and then go on the inside here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he tried, but he couldn't.
Yeah, when Winter's ghost done. It just goes so very hard. You can see all the rubber going down to this track. That's amazing to see.
And I can just see through the Dick Story's sign there that the fastest lap is a 1:35. So quite decent laps coming from these guys.
Yeah, I would say that it's impressive that all the times are very equal to all full splits.
I don't think the splits is that separated at the moment.
No.
No, but I think it will do once, for example, people have finished, mostly nowadays it's their exams. A lot of people have exams at the moment, so they're not practicing a lot. So I think we'll see a difference from some people after June.
I also think a lot of people don't like these first tracks, so that's probably why everyone is hating so they're bad at
second. I think we're going to see some way more split times when you're going to Europe again. And
we can start seeing the rain out here.
Spain. Oh, that's a move done or what? Oh, that's... Yeah, he got the DRS, so that should be moved on, I think.
Will Winters be able to stay on the inside and then just push out?
No. Maybe...
But will he dive bomb? I think he will.
He will.
Yeah, that's coming.
Where the fuck is he? There he is.
I don't think that was specified as a dive bomb.
I think he's too far back, in my opinion.
He lost a lot of time in that narrow corner compared to Armstrong.
He's coming back though.
Coming. Oh, that's nice cutting.
Cuts away.
And Vasca cutting a little wide. That's just. Oh, Vasca. And that's a loud fast cut.
Second time you do that to me, man.
Well, that's Medify.
In second at the moment, we'll see.
In second, so that's Steel, but probably going past. And that's. Oh, that's Medify breaking himself out totally there.
Yeah, Vasca was actually just keeping his line up there, I think.
Exactly.
That's pretty crazy.
Oh, and that's Winters going up to the inside again.
Oh, how did that happen?
I don't know, but that's a podium for Winters so far. Two laps to go. That's a very interesting battle to watch now. This is, 15 points to get.
Yeah, but remember, initialization is also catching up to Armstrong now, so he might be able to. The other
it's a three-way battle.
Next, I see him right behind him, so that's a very interesting battle.
I think it's McLaren, Red Bull right now.
So it's a McLaren sandwich.
Yeah, but then again, initialization is in the Red Bull sandwich as well.
Oh, he's showing his mark right up to his rear tire now. That's initialization is really pushing Armstrong to the max limit now. And,
Armstrong's tires are starting to it looks like there is some grass on his right tire.
Exactly. Also, you can see that the fire. Oh, and that's.
Oh, that's it. That's it. He's given the place and maybe the place back to his teammate as well.
Yeah.
That's an umbrella.
Yeah, that's.
Where's Yava?
I don't know.
Yava probably might.
Oh, that's team battle going up. Oh, that's initialization going in for inside, I think. No.
Winters is still ahead, but now initialization might try to come with the DRS.
Oh, this.
May I just remind you of Turkey 2010, where Red Bull take themselves out. So.
I think it's probably maybe a recap that I am not sure, but this is very interesting battle to us.
I think there is no team order set, this is just battle to the end.
Exactly. Yeah. French racing, the two great Brits are fighting for the podium. Yeah, but still.
Oh, it's the same thing.
It doesn't matter.
I didn't even notice that there was two different flags for England when I was in this game. So you know.
I don't know why. It's just do what I have to. Sometimes,
I took
sometimes
one. I don't know which.
Sometimes it's England and sometimes Great Britain. It's
say that.
Depends on the mood.
Oh, and that's... Oh, man. Armstrong are really trying to push initialization to do something stupid, and...
I just think he's waiting down here, just hoping for initialization Winters to fuck it up for each other.
Oh, that's...
Which they probably will at some point, looking at that.
Oh, this is very...
A bit more than a lap to go now.
Yeah, and that's... Oh, that's...
Also, what I've noticed is... Armstrong taking a good line through that corner, getting very close coming into these corners.
He's showing up in the rear mirror now. Oh, that's insulation.
Oh, Max completely outbreaks himself, but he keeps it on track. That was just now,
so that's a Christian. Oh, that's amazing. Battle was this.
Oh, snap. We might be in for an exciting finish in the last lap.
Oh, that's a decision showing us. Oh, that's...
Can Winters come on the inside? I know it's Armstrong going past.
Yeah, but Winters will have DRS.
Yeah, but Armstrong got it too, and we know Winters is struggling with some straight line pace as we're seeing through the race.
It doesn't look like he is there.
Contact!
And there we go, Winters has got the place back.
Go
around the outside.
And now the Lotus is coming as well.
Racing.
And Lotus is coming in to mix with the battle now.
And Armstrong is really getting into some weird action now. I must say this is
amazing. I think initialization is gone down the road now. He's going to get that podium.
Armstrong is showing his...
And a Lotus is on his outside now.
Lotus is going for the...
There goes Lotus!
That's contact that too.
So... Oh god, I can't predict who's going to win this battle.
Oh, both Winters and Crawler is going right
there. I think up too.
It's time for another session of bets, lads. Who's going to win?
Insulation.
apart from Winters.
Oh, that's Winters going into the ground.
Not Winters.
I'm going to bet for Winters, so, you know, he failed.
I would say it looks like Armstrong is having problems with his tyres now, so I think Crawler has just moved away.
I think that's it. The podium positions have been determined now.
Exactly. Well, that's bad luck for Winters, locking up down to that half, and it's real difficult.
Especially on the last lap, losing two positions. That's just too bad.
Yeah, never good, is it?
Still about winning the race.
That's quite good, since, if you remember, he was being stopped in the first one corner.
You're trying to reverse the track around.
Yeah, he was trying to go
Oh, and yeah, I think, yeah, that this is... That's his realization going for his podium at third place.
Yeah, there we go. He gets podium. Armstrong gets, fifth, and Winters sixth. So, yeah, that was a really interesting race.
I would say this is an amazing finish of this race. By far the best one so far in the season. And also...
What do you want?
I just want to say that Stilbert did an amazing job.
Was actually quite awesome that he managed to get from, last up to the top and had to catch up with everyone as well.
Exactly.
Had a fine second and then, of course, initialization in third.
And then also got a 4.5 second gap.
And here we can see the championship. Stilbert is now in the lead with 20 points down to Kroll.
That's a big points gap.
Yeah, but then again, you can say one race more, then Kroll might be able to get up there if Stilbert is having a bad day.
Exactly, but I must say this is a very close point table, I must say.
Oh, and Bicecar is not last. There's three cars behind him. That's amazing.
Yeah, probably three cars that have not started any races. Is that right?
Jorak have not seen Jorak.
Both Vin and Kaneska have been there, so.
Well, but thanks for watching. We'll see you guys in Bahrain.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.